My name is Rhapsody of Realities.
Hello, welcome to today's edition of Rhapsody of Realities Reading Party. God bless you. Today is Wednesday, 3rd March, our year of preparation. Our theme today is Have No Fear of Man. And our theme scripture is from Nehemiah chapter 4, verse 14. Be not ye afraid of them. Remember the Lord, which is great and terrible. And fight for your brethren, your sons, your daughters, your wives, and your houses. Pastor Chris said, many years ago, while I was in the university, the government of the day, a military government, banned all religious activities on campus. Some of the members of our fellowship came to convince me to comply, but I had heard from God. He told me to remain on campus. Some of them weren't ready to stand with me, perhaps because they were afraid. But if God had told me to continue, why should I stop because of what someone said? Always, God's word and counsel or counsel to you is what counts. He made the vice chancellor, governor, president, prime minister, etc. The Bible says, the powers that be are ordained of him. He put them in office. If they go rogue against him by coming up with laws and policies that don't favor his righteous cause, you are not obliged to comply. No authority supersedes God's authority. So, I went ahead with a program I had scheduled on campus because I had rather obeyed God. And it was remarkable success. Hallelujah. Consequently, we were never stopped from holding services on campus till I graduated. Was I defying the government? No, I was only obeying the orders of a higher government. It was the same with the apostles. Peter and the other apostles confronted the authorities in their day. Once they said, you yourself judge which is right in God's sight, to obey you or to obey God. Acts chapter 4, verse 19. As a man or woman of God, as a Christian, as one who walks with God, have no fear of men. Have no fear of their laws or decrees. Have no fear of anything. The Bible says, there is no wisdom against the Lord. Proverbs chapter 21, verse 30. Human beings can never come together and come up with enough wisdom or strategy against God. It's impossible. When you are walking in sync with His plan and purpose for your life, it makes no difference what anyone thinks or does. It doesn't matter the threats. You win. Say, I will win. The opposition may come from your family, your city, your country, or government. Have no fear, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. For further studies, you read Psalm 27, verse 1 to 3, Acts chapter 5, verse 25 to 29, 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. If you are on the 1-year Bible reading plan, you read the scriptures down the 1-year Bible reading plan. If you are on the 2-year Bible reading plan, you also follow the scriptures down the 2-year Bible reading plan. It's confession time. Say these words after me. I'm confident in the power of God's word to put me over always. irrespective of the circumstances or opposition. I stand in faith against any law, decree, government or individuals who have set themselves against the Church of Jesus Christ. And I declare that their defenses is gone from them. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God bless you for watching, and we would like you to join any Christ Embassy Church around the world or Christ Embassy Church closer to you. But if we're in Ghana, Kumasi, you can locate us at Kwadaso. We are just opposite the Natoni gas filling station. God bless you.
If you've never received salvation, if you've never received Christ into your heart, if you've never experienced this life of Christ that I'm talking to you about, this is your moment. Say these words. Say, oh Lord God, I believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God. I believe He died to save me. I believe God raised Him from the dead, and He's alive today. I confess with my mouth, Jesus Christ is Lord of my life from this day. And by my faith in Him, I receive eternal life into my heart, into my spirit. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. I have eternal life now. I'm a child of God now. I am born again. Thank you, Lord.
If you just said that prayer along with Pastor Chris, congratulations. Welcome to the family of God.
We are an altar of broken stones, but you delight in the offering. You have the heavens to call your home, but you abide.